Welcome back to The Witcher. I am Shox, and let's slay some ghouls. How about that? Bring it, ghoul. And I really have to make sure not to get hit that often, because I already took damage again, and it was just fighting one single ghoul. Okay, now, probably shouldn't dodge into three different ghouls at the same time. Oh, that was bad. Yeah, see, the strong attacks are pretty hard to time. And I have to get better at actually doing my attacks. And please keep... No, don't shoot your sword. God damn it. That was bad. Oh no! Damn it. He killed me. Yeah, I have to be much more careful. I have to dodge more. I'm going into the battle too aggressively, and I don't let them come at me. I think I use, this sign. That looks like a good sign for this battle. And I might have to pick my enemies a little more strategically, like one at a time. And actually block more. I think even if I do an attack, if I immediately go over to blocking, it should still allow me to block a lot, or give me a good chance of blocking his next attack. So there are three at the same time. That might be a little much. So let's get out of here. Just dodge, come on. Yeah. That's another thing, like, if you're not quite in combat, he doesn't roll, so it becomes the sprint button. So that irritates me sometimes as well. So you seem, kinda low now. Right, one at a time, if possible. Isolated you, dodged you, and then I sliced you to pieces. Alright. Even though I blocked, he still paralyzed me because I guess just the sheer force of him running at me. But yeah, this one was way better. This was a way better engagement because I didn't just blindly run into the enemy, but actually magic. Think.
A place of power.
Magic. So let's see what we found here. Let's save before we go there.
Ghoul nest. Ought to just destroy it.
Okay, so we need, we need bombs to destroy the nests. Then again, we could just come back and, I guess, farm the ghouls as soon as we, they respawn. What is this? Need to draw. Oh, nice. So when I discover those things, I get ability points.
Ghoul nest. Ought to just destroy it.
Nice. So the Gwen sign intensity has increased. Can I see that somewhere here? Character. I wonder if I can see what this did. If there's any indication. Oh, so... So alchemy, I think, is all the things I discovered and all the bombs I can craft. And, if I buy things, it would show up here. But, I don't think I see my ability points here. Or can I still spend a point? Oh, yeah, I have 2 points available. That's great. I guess I did not spend my point here. Okay, I want to do that. And yeah. So what happens to those? So these just get better over time. But for now, I think I really want to focus on this. And just get my attacks to become better. And improve this ability. Yeah, so it should have saved my points. I should have, like, two points in this now. Oh, so basically it is a temporary effect for 30 minutes. My Gwensign will be stronger, and I gained a ability point, which, you know, that was permanent. I just keep walking over here and see if there's anything of interest. Not really a lot. Let's just go through here and see if anything specific pops up. Otherwise, we will look at what quests we have left and what we want to work on next. Obviously, the main quest is to chase after what's her name again? I forgot. Yennefer. So we have one more left on Death's Bed. We want a brew a potion that allows her to survive, or, you know, die in pain, but it is her only chance that she has at all. Otherwise, she's certain to die. So, okay, brew a dose of the swallow potion. Let's see what I need for that. I call bombs, decoctions, potions. Swallow potions. So what we need is Celandine. So we have a drowner brain, so we need Celandine. Can we somehow, like, track specifically that? I doubt it. All right.
Come on.
So we just have to walk through here and find the right ingredients. So what is this?
Take it easy.
Okay, it doesn't tell me, so I just have to, I guess, walk up and identify how it looks. So this is white myrtle petals. This is not what we need. Let's just keep looking. This is purple, you know, also nothing that we need for this specific potion. So let's just keep walking around and hopefully we stumble upon one of those blowball, verbena. Celandine, yeah, that's exactly the one we need. So how many of those do we need? I think we needed a bunch of them. We need 5, so we need to find, I think, 2 more plants. Yeah, and there are ghouls down there, which I don't really care to fight. Just because it's such a bad terrain, just for us specifically, it's hard to dodge in there. I think that's one more. No, that's blowball. It's a different one. So yeah, there's a lot of ingredients around here, so I hope it doesn't take us too long to actually find the right ingredients. Well, so far we only find the wrong ingredients. Well, maybe we can make use of those as well and take a look at the potions we can actually make. And while we're doing this, we also explore the world a little bit more, which is also very interesting. Another one of those. Yeah, let's just go in that general direction where we actually found the first one. There was one that we needed. Blowball, still the wrong one. But it was actually right next to one of those, so I think we might just be going in the right direction where those actually grow. It's one of those. I think it was a just a yellow straw or something. And this is, I think. Oh, these might be the ones we're looking for. Yes, someone did. I think we need one more plant to be able to craft it. Oh no, we need two more plants. Alright, so... yes, there's one more. And let's see if there's one over there as well. Yes! Looks like it. So... oops, wrong button. Let's see, do we have enough? Yes, we can brew a swallow potion. Very good. And there was a letter here. What does it say? Bandits calling Zemps to Temeria soldiers. We already know that they're hiding in the nearby woods. The question is, did we already kill those? Or are they still out there? Because if they're still out there, we might just go and hunt them down. Anyhow, now that we have the potion, let's just go through the woods as usual. There's a house that I didn't... oh yeah, I did check out the house. It's the one that all the guys were in front of. Oh, what happened here? Lost your dad? Can't talk to you? I'm sorry, boy. War times suck. Let's keep going. Yeah, those are the guys that we can't hit, apparently. Just right in that direction. I know it's not exactly where we're supposed to go, but I hope we can make a left turn. No, that's where we just came from. So we can't really make a left turn. We just have to right back and go down there. And then just right around this rock. And I wonder how we can get up there. It is really weird. I mean, I'd just say craft a ladder and just go up there. But I'm not sure if that is an option here that, you know, I can do. And if I remember correctly, there was a place that was undiscovered right around here. So actually, let's discover that location first. Before we move on. Just so we don't have to come back here. And those aquatic dudes. We probably have to slay and get some brains from them as a nice side effect that we can use for crafting. Actually, no, alchemy, not crafting. And I don't think we can actually use our horse attack here, sadly. Because, yeah, let's try it anyway. Yeah, turning around will be hard, but we can. Oh.
Come on.
Yeah, just please line up nicely. Oh, there's another treasure. And Horace was about to just toss me off. And...
hey there.
Oh, why the fuck would you put it back? Alright, I want to aim for you. Because you're... just missed here again.
Take it easy.
Let me attack you. Yeah, that hit nice. See, being on the horse is really nice for attacking. Especially those kind of enemies. Because they don't, they don't really chase after me. Ah, oh, missed. God damn it. Ah, so the horse got scared. Oh, way too many. Especially at like one spot. Come here, Drowner. Oh, so I can basically disable him. Come here and die. There you go. And... oh, what is this? Did that hurt me? I don't know what happened here. Like, why was this, you know, doing that effect? So the question is, was it because I actually did, like, a really good block? Or, like, it just hurt me? Or I actually jumped on one of those barrels that exploded? Let us take a look, though, at all the loot. First, loot all the bodies from the drowners. Well, let's take a look at the loot. We have an armor, string, food, and a water hack decoction. And here we have money, linen, Temerian poniard, and a tonal owl. Alright, that was pretty successful for us, I'd say. So let's continue, eat more food, and let's actually take a look at the armor. That sounded pretty shiny. All the swords are worse, but this armor is a big improvement compared to the armor we have right now. So we get 10 more armor. Resistance to piercing damage is new. Resistance to bludgeoning damage is 3% more. No, actually, 8% more. And resistance to slashing damage is also 5% more, but we, again, lose resistance to elemental damage, but that is totally worth it. And I absolutely love this gear because he's now wearing the Bavarian flag. Hell yeah. I love it. Let me see. Do you have anything on you? All right, so I actually might use art here. Just to toss them out of my way to begin with. Oh shit, you killed me instantly? Wow. I did not expect this. What happened here? I think I just jumped into his attack, but that was weird. Alright, so what sign do we have? We have this sign. Let's just do the fire damage one. And again, you know, I was just running into it blindly. And the range was not far enough for this to work. I'll just pull out my crossbow then if you don't want to come to me. I'll help you. Yeah, I don't think the crossbow does anything just because, dodge. Right. So he tosses me back too. So just standing there and blocking is actually not that good of a move because it will set me back, knock me back, and I feel kind of, you know, get me off my balance. So I can counterattack for a bit. I guess I just have to get better at timing it. So I actually do immediately do a counterattack. And yeah, like those two were close to actually killing me. Wow. This is pretty bad. I'm going through a lot of food just to not immediately die here. And these are like not even quest relevant creatures. This is all just stuff that's basically on the side of the road. Let's call our horse up to us. Let's go to the herbalist and see if we can save this woman or if she will die in horrible pain. Of course, we hope we were able to self her, to help her. But if that is not possible, well, we at least tried. And I think Geralt would always pick the... oh, wow, what the hell is going on over there? I think the bandits are over there, and there are a bunch of them, and it's in the forest, so it's very hard for me to attack with my horse. so I should be very careful with that bandit camp. But we might try it later, just to see how our abilities hold up against a bunch of those bandits. And, you know, just to see if we can handle them. Ah, goes through there. Come on! No time to relax here. He, I think, is also a merchant that I should talk to. Oh, actually, no, I can sell all my stuff to him right now. Let's see if he buys my stuff.
We meet again.
Thank you for saving me.
Oh, it's you.
People say all kinds of things about witches, but I've always known yours to be an honorable guild.
So you managed to salvage some goods?
Yes, but I await the repair of my wagon. As time passes, my losses grow. Do you need something? I'll let it go half free.
Let me have a look at your stock.
All right, what does he have that would be useful to us? This is really good armor, but it requires level 4, but we are soon level 4, so we should probably come back. It's also pretty expensive. He only has 160 gold, so let's see how much we can sell this stuff for. Yeah, it's only 24.4, so it's not a lot of gold, so we have to get a lot of swords just to make a little bit of money off of it. Mace. Yeah, they're all much worse in armor class or damage and anything, so I just sell them all. This is the only one that's actually better, so I'll keep that one. And considering I have 250 gold now, let's see, maybe we want to buy something. How much is that? That's 230 gold, but it's plus 25 armor, so I really like that option. Then again,
take care.
We might want to craft something. And that is usually better than what you can buy. So maybe we don't want to waste our money just yet, or like spend our money just that yet rather. And see what we can craft and how we can craft. And maybe we have to invest into materials. Everything's gonna be fine. But if that ends up to give us better armor, I have no problem spending the money on the materials instead of a pre-made armor. Ah, come on, horse. Interesting pathfinding. Just running head first into the wall. But yeah, let's go to the herbalist and give the potion to the troubled lady. And maybe even talk to the herbalist and...
Not so fast, Roach.
She might have ingredients that we need for potions, and maybe take a look at the potions we can craft and whether we want to craft some of those right now.
Yes?
Got a potion for Lena. Swallow.
First sign of spring. Symbol of rebirth. Fitting as names go.
We'll see. Like I said, could harm her deeply. Works on me immediately. But I have a faster metabolism. Effects won't appear in her case for a few days.
Why'd you choose this in the end?
Decided it was better than doing nothing.
I like you, Witcher. Here. A small gift. For giving a damn.
Nice, I think we got a bunch of stuff. When I saw that, like, just going by, of sweat and blood. A veil hangs between the world man see and the one they cannot. This veil blocks the dead from the view of the living, and the living from the view of the dead. So mages can break through this veil and communicate with the dead.
while summon them to the world of the sun for short periods of time. This is the art known as necromancy. The dead also can break through the veil and enter the world of the living of their own. Yet unlike the necromancers, in doing so, they are not driven by reason and will, but by a thoughtless, irrational need. This need arises from powerful emotions such as regret, longing, or wrath. Very often, these emotions gain their power by being invested in material object by the dead individual while he or she still knew life. The objects most frequently so endowed? Wedding rings, favorite toys, or the instrument used for the crime which sent the returned individual to the other world in the first place. Interesting. And we got some crafting ingredients from her, and we have a bunch of them, so we should take a look what we can craft right now and what she can sell us.
Yes.
And we got a bunch of experience for this as well.
Got any herbs you're willing to sell?
I'm sure I can find something.
So she also has gloves and manuscripts. So this is alcohol, regenerates vitality during and outside of combat. Troll decoction. So I still have to figure out what the difference between decoctions and essences and all the other things is. But
farewell.
So far, talk to you later, maybe. So I think now it is the time to move on with the main quest. Actually, there's one more contract we have left. Ask Odilon about the contract. In White Orchid, Geralt happened across a notice posted by a certain Odilon residing in the village. The man wanted someone to take out the monster who was haunting the area around an old well, and doing so required a professional. This was as typical of Witcher work as they come, so Geralt decided to talk to the man. Alright, I think we will do that quest before we move on to find Jessica. See, where do we have to go? Oh, it's really close. So we can just ride there. Where you at, Roach? Oh, I don't want to come up here. Are you bugged? Alright, I come to you, stubborn horse. Let's go. Gallop it is. Oh, and a tree where stuck it is as well. Heavy traffic on the road. Hey, it should be really close here. I think one of the next buildings. I can see it on the map. So here it is, this building. So Odilon probably lives here.
Hey.
What's up, Odilon? I'm the witcher you were asking for.
Greetings, good man. Having trouble with your well? That's what I read.
Aye. 'Tis haunted. Has been for a good 20 years.
20? So why'd you put out a notice just now?
'Cause earlier on we drew our water from the river. But so many corpses floating in it after the battle has turned noxious. My daughter Mandy drank half a pitcher. Felt dreadful ill. Can't keep nothing down. She grows worse by the day. Herbalist claims you fight a fever with drink. And not beer nor cider, but water. Clear, pure water. And where am I to get that if not from the well? But first, the ghost's got to be driven away. And it don't let any man near.
This ghost. Describe it for me.
Well, it's awful frightening. Awful.
I meant, what does it look like?
It looks like a woman, but fresh from the grave. Wears a dirty dress, all rags, its skin flaking off its bones, and it howls like it's suffering.
Some wraith, or maybe an alp.
If you don't wallop it, master,
If you don't take care of it, that is, it'll come kill me daughter.
Well, I mean, it is a contract, so let's talk about my reward.
I feel for you, but this is my job, so let's talk about my pay.
Something not right with the coin.
To haggle for a higher reward, choose an amount. Confirm your choice by pressing A. If your counterparty accepts your offer, you made a deal. If your offer is too high, your counterparty will grow annoyed. Push too hard, and he or she will break off negotiations. This is 25.
If you could drop your price a bit, I'm sure we'd agree.
Alright, 23. Alright, I shall help you.
Where's this well?
In Havel, a settlement on the heights. It's abandoned now, no one ventures there on account of the ghost being about. Drive it off, please.
Alright, let's drive off this wraith, or whatever spirit that is. Where you at, Roach? Oh, you're bugged behind a fence again? Yes. Nope, don't jump in there. There, stay here, Roach. Thank you. Witcher 3, the story of struggling to get on a damn horse.
Slow now.
Let's see where this wraith is on the map. Oh, it is down here. So we basically just have to follow the road. And I think I came by that.
That's it, Roach.
Wraith a bit earlier already. So let's see if this is actually the place we came by earlier and just decided to leave because it was pretty scary. Or if it is a new place. It is an abandoned village. Alright, but before we fight the wraith, we will put a cut in this video. Thank you so much for following this episode of The Witcher. I'm Shox, and see you next time.